Welcome to the Coromandel Peninsula. We're at a little spot called Sandy Bay, right near the top of Coro. And today, Mick, we've left the boat behind.
We have. We're off the bricks today, land-based fishing for snapper, kingfish, carwai, trevally, well, whatever swims in the burley trail.
Yep, we've got plenty of burley, so I think it's time to load up the little dinghy, head up the coast and get into it.
Yeah, but before we get too carried away, straight into the Radio Hierarchy Challenge
and Consequence.
The challenge is to cast and hit the other person in the face with a dirty mackerel, and the consequence is to wear a bread suit and hang out with a bunch of seagulls.
All right, mate, challenge time.
Yeah, mate.
You looking forward to getting hit in the face with this?
Oh, mate, you're looking forward to getting hit in the face with that.
Yeah, we'll see. All right, so paper, scissors, rocks, I'll see who goes first.
Let's give it a go.
As we do. Oh, so you'll start.
I'll start, yeah.
Here you go.
Why not?
Let's do it.
Here we go.
That was close.
Oh, got the arm.
Oh, glancing blow there, mate. After a few casts, that's what we're dealing with.
Oh, Jesus. Oh, no! God damn it!
Yes!
Disgusting.
Did you get a bit in the mouth?
Yeah, well, look at the thing.
Oh, man, that's... That was good, Mick.
Disgusting. That's a consequence in its own right.
Oh, well, that's enough of that. Challenge done, and...
Some fishing, eh?
Fishing it is. Yeah. Let's go.
What do you do when the wind is blowing 25 knots and you need to go fishing? You find an area that is somewhat sheltered from the wind and get into some land-based action. One area which ticks all the boxes for big snapper during a westerly is the eastern side of the Coromandel Peninsula. Our mate Gene grew up in Sandy Bay and he also runs a fishing page on Facebook called Fitty Angler. So we got in touch and he, along with a couple of mates, Noel and Sammy, joined us in making the trek up the coast to Port Charles. The plan was to load up all the gear into a dinghy and find a good ledge to burley up a storm and hopefully hook into some solid winter reds. Winter is a great time to target the biggest snapper off the rocks, and although the fishing isn't always hard and fast, you'll sometimes get a shot at that epic trophy snapper. After a quick scout around, we found a perfect looking ledge with plenty of room that we could safely unload all our gear onto, so it was time to rig up and get some baits in the water.
Right, so first things first, we've got to get the burley in the water. Before we're getting all our baits in, getting our rods set up, we're going to get the burley in, get those fish fired up so when our baits are in the water, hopefully, fish will already be there. So, Mick, you're going to rig yourself up with a sort of unweighted stray line rig.
Fresh strip of carwai there. I've whipped the scales off purely just to make it a little easier to rig. I've got a two hook snail rig, both quite close together. In and out. Those hooks quite close together, barbs well exposed, a half inch around the top, just to hold it all together. That gets rid of the pickers, and hopefully we'll pick up the big boys.
For snapper fishing, normally we'd use around 60 pound, 40, but because we're in the rocks here and it's all reefy, sharp rocks around the edges, you do need a bit of abrasion resistance there, so fluorocarbon's ideal, and it's 80 pound. And I've got probably about a metre and a half to 2 metres of that, tied onto my main line, which is braid. So that's 50 pound braid. That's tied on there with a back-to-back uni knot. I'm running just a single recurve hook. A couple of reasons for that. One is because you get a lot of snags with the J hooks, the regular J hooks. With the recurve hook, you get a lot fewer snags. So this gets stuck in the weed, it just rolls past the weed, which is great, obviously, because you're out fishing, there's a lot of weed around where we are. So that's one of the reasons. The other reason is because when you do hook a fish, very rarely does it come off. So recurves are great for that. 80 pound fluoro, just tying that straight on with a nice simple uni knot. And I just like to use a 1, 2, 3, 4 turn uni knot. Pull it tight there, not too tight, just so it's snug. Wet the line to avoid it from burning. Pull it nice and tight. Then we just trim that tag end, and that's it. Nice and simple, but very effective. So with this, I can rig all sorts of different types of baits, nice and simply, nice and quickly, get them straight back out there again. And hopefully, hook on some nice snapper.
The method is simple for targeting the big boys: burley, patience, and unweighted baits. Without any boat noise or shadows to spook the fish, you'll find they'll often feed directly beneath your feet.
Yep, right there. Woohoo! Ah, first fish of the spot. Got him, Mig?
Yeah, nice, mate.
Well, they always start off small, usually. And being my first fish for the spot, I might put this guy back. Definitely a keeper, but we'll let him go. Just below our feet there, that's where they seem to be taking the baits at the moment. So, as we say, it's a good thing with the land-based fishing. You can get them right in front of you. You on, Mig?
Nah.
He's in the bush.
Do you want to come fishing with us? We've got the opportunity for you and a mate to win the ultimate fishing trip, and we'll be your hosts for the day. By grabbing yourself some of our seriously cool merchandise, you'll go straight in the draw to win a big fish mission with the Fishing and Adventure crew. We've got our very own genuine illicit t-shirts and snapback caps available, so head on over to fishingandadventure.co.nz, score yourself some gear, and it could be you landing that epic catch.
That's a mean fish off the bricks.
Come on! Yeah. Yeah.
We're on a serious land-based mission at the top of the Coromandel, and Mig lost the mackerel casting challenge. With the gear all set up and the burley running, we've already had a bit of action from smaller snapper and kawai.
Definitely got to have patience and perseverance when fishing off the rocks. Just got to wait, sit through the tides, wait for the fish to come in. They come and go, change your baits up, sizes, styles. Work the different areas, not just directly below you, but out a bit further, around to the side, just wherever you can, because we're not targeting an effective school of fish, it's more just sort of individual fish cruising around, so the burley will bring them in, but at the same time, they're not all going to be directly around where our burley is. They could be anywhere around here, so keep on mixing it up. Keep on sticking at it, though. Got him. Kawai. Yep. Woohoo! Got the roll on, Jerry. Sweet. We got our fresh bait, Mig.
Yeah, mate. We need that.
Recurve hooks, I should stay in. Yep. Sweet. We're getting low on bait, so this guy's a welcome sight. So Kawai make fantastic snapper bait, so what I'm going to do, bang this guy on the head and kill him. And then whip a side off and probably split that in half and turn that into a one bait. So we'll get about four or five baits off this one fish. Sweet, so that fillets off there. All right, so you saw the way Mig rigged up his whole flapper kawai. Mine's a little bit different because I'm running a single hook rig. Nice and simple. That's just hooked straight through the top there, from the flesh side through the skin. That just sits nice and naturally. And that'll actually stay there for quite a while on the hook. The pickers can have a go at it, but it'll stay there because it's a nice, solid bit of kawai with the skin on. So that's the way I've rigged that up. And I'm gonna fire that out into the burley zone and hopefully get an even bigger fish than the last one.
Although the wind was gusting, the sun came out and the snapper and kawai were responding to our burley. The scenery alone was reason enough to keep us interested, but the signs were there to suggest we're in for a cracker of an afternoon session.
Yeah. Oh. Yeah.
Right, Scotty.
Yeah, bro, good fish.
Good fish?
Not a bad one.
Need the net, nah.
Nah, should be right. He should be right, he's not massive. He's not bad, though. Yeah, net him in, man. Is he in there? Is he in there? Around the back, eh? Yeah, hey. Right. Woo!
Nice.
Sweet. Oh, we're getting better. He swallowed that hook down. That was a recurve hook. And I thought he'd taken it but it was sort of, it went over the back of the ledge, so I couldn't feel whether it was the current pulling my hook around or whether he'd swallowed it. But look at that, right down. That's a mean fish off the bricks.
Yeah.
Stoked with that. It's only early days as well, so fingers crossed we can get on some more of these guys and or bigger. But because he swallowed the hook, I'm probably going to keep him, and we're here to get a feed as well, so that's a beautiful filleting size. With the Okuma Trio, it's got a little bait feeder set up on the back here, which is perfect for this kind of fishing. We flick that little lever, it disengages the main drag, and we're in free spool. It's adjustable at the back, so we can adjust the tension there slightly. That's ideal to let those bigger snapper grab the bait, run away with it without feeling any of the resistance. And then when you think they've got in their mouth, you can just either turn the handle or flick that little lever, and then you're back to your main drag again and you fight them. Solid, solid bites there. Come on, run away with it, friend. He's got to be patient, got to let him swallow it. It's a big bait. He's got it now. Come on. Come on. Oh, yeah, 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 good run. Yep. Alrighty. Hooked up, yeah, not bad.
Need the net?
Oh, I'll be alright, bro, I'll lift him in. It's not a bad one though, just another nice benchy.
Solid.
There he comes.
It's quite hard in that shallow water, eh?
Hell yeah. Skull drag him up. Got the leader there, Mick. Woohoo! Mean.
Woohoo!
Oh, she's not hard and fast, but that's land-based fishing. You take these every now and again, eh, Mick?
Yeah, mate. That's bang on.
Offer. Beauty.
That's good stuff.
Look at that whole side of Kawai. Hungry little bugger. It's gotta be its beautiful eating size, so I'm just gonna ick him in the head with the knife there. Just behind that eye into that soft part of the skull. And now he's dead. Pop him in the chili bin with the ice with the other ones. And continue to, hopefully, get some more of these fellas.
Burley is the key to bringing the fish in and triggering a bite. So always check and replace it when necessary, as you never know when those trophy snaps will cruise on by.
We got a good one.
Whoa, 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 get him up, bro. Yeah, bro. Keep him up, man. That's a big fish.
It's a solid one.
Hell yeah. Stay with him, Sammy.
That rain turned them on, I think.
It's a big one. That's it, man. Yeah, he's coming, he's coming. So Sammy just hooked up to a beast. Hasn't been much happening, and then all of a sudden, bang. Yeah, bro, that's a mean fish.
Oh, yeah.
Here, boy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's a stonker.
Yes.
Well done, bro.
Yes.
Stop, bro. Well done.
That's a stonker. That's got to hit 20, man. Well, we didn't catch it, but we're bloody stoked to see it come on the rocks. Doesn't matter.
Yeah.
It's a mean fish.
Short, bro. Solid.
Nice fish.
Yeah, definitely a nice fish. So Sammy's decided he's going to let this fish go. Which is mean, because obviously it was a quite a quick fight, dragging him up, so this fish should have enough life. So he's just going to let him swim away. Yeah, bro, on this one. Is he going to go? Yeah, bro. Yeah, there he goes. Mean. Doesn't matter who catches it, man. That's awesome.
I'd have to steal one of these bloody mackerel everyone's talking about.
It's
Today for your F&A Essentials product of the week, we're talking about the lures you like to use in the show, in particular, stick baits, soft baits, and jigs.
We use the gear from Savage. These little prawns here are some of the soft baits we like to use. Durable, nice action. These are great for your big snapper, trevally, kingies, and all that sort of stuff. And there's another one of our favorites here is the Savage Eel. Awesome big snapper bait, eh, Mike?
Yep, and kingies love them as well. Squish jigs, lethal on big snapper in the deeper water, and hooks so sharp they'll go straight through your finger.
Stick baits for your kingies and larger pelagic species, and these trolling lures, which are also great for the kingfish.
They have an awesome range, including these little lures for baitfish as well.
So check out the gear from Savage, which is our product of the week.
Yeah, that's a beast, that's a beast.
Yeah.
It's a serious land-based mission up at Port Charles, and the fishing is heating up big time. We're fishing alongside our mates, and Sammy has set the bar extremely high with his first ever 20-pound snapper, which was released to fight another day.
Yep.
Tighten that drag up.
Okay, right. Oh! I just pulled the hook.
That was a stonker too, eh?
Oh, f***. Pulled the hook, it was a recurve too. Damn it! Oh, yep, yes, big! That's a good fish.
Yeah, it's a turn him around.
Short, sharp pumps. I lost my head, but that's it doesn't matter.
Don't worry about that. You sort that out later.
Yeah, here he comes. I saw some colour there. Keep him up, or you got the ledge now. Oh, yeah, it's a beast. Yes, big.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Oh,
yes.
Sick. It's another solid snap.
Yeah, bro. He's still fresh, eh?
He's still so green. Stoked, man.
Oh,
man, so mean.
Hey.
Oh, solid. Get him up on the bricks.
Yeah.
Woo. Stoked as that.
That's
fish.
Your best napper off the bricks, though.
Oh, yeah.
If you had again, I'll get him.
She's trying conditions, but who cares when you're pulling these guys off the bricks? So mean. Sweet.
Let's get him back in the drink.
We'll let this fish go. Sweet. That's
right. Oh, here he goes.
Oh, off he goes. He was keen then.
Right. Here he goes.
There he goes.
Is he going to go? Come on, man.
Oh,
go.
Come on now.
Yes.
Unbelievable, eh? You can catch these fish off the bricks. You can do it off the boat, but there's something special about catching these big monster snapper off the bricks. You just lock the drag and hope for the best.
Oh, that's a good run, Mick. Hit him. Yeah, that's a beast. That's a beast. Get him up. Get him up. That's another big one. Get him up, Mick. Yes. Don't fall in. Stay with him, stay with him. Yeah, keep his head up, that's it.
Yeah.
Keep it up, keep it up. Oh, yes. Come on. Doing well, man, doing well. Yeah, he ain't far away. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. That's a beast.
Yeah.
Yay!
Holy shit! What a day on the bricks, man. What a day on the bricks.
Oh, that's got to go close, mate. On that little scraggly bit of car wire.
Scraggly bit of car wire had a pilly on there as well.
Oh, man. That's annihilated,
eh? Man, he was going for it, eh?
Yeah, sick. Yeah, he was, man. That was a good scrap. Single recurve hook right in the corner of the mouth. Beautifully. Out it comes. Hold him up, man. Get him in the light.
Oh, yeah.
That's a beast.
Sick.
Nice fish.
So we'll slap this guy back as well. We've got a full bin.
He's coming back to have a look, is he?
What an awesome day on the bridge.
Yeah, bro.
Cheers, bro.
Mean.
So good.
Those are two epic fish, man.
Yeah.
You've got to be stoked with that.
Loved it, and it's been a good session for all the boys.
Oh, definitely. We've had an absolute blast, you know?
Nah,
doesn't matter who's catching the fish, as long as someone's catching them.
Yep.
And it's just mean to see those big fish come up and then let them go again.
Yeah, bloody solid.
Solid effort, man. All right, so we'll cruise on back and what do you reckon? Consequence time.
Consequence time, mate.
Let's do it.
What an absolutely awesome day fishing off the rocks, and a massive thanks to our mate Gene for helping us get onto the fish. For all the fishing news and info from the Coromandel, head over and follow Fitty Angler on Facebook.
Oh! Oh, ow. Oh, I'm pooed on so many
pooed
times.
On them. So the consequence isn't working as well as expected. So I'm going to have to make something out of it. So we've got a nice mackerel sandwich here.
What's in your hand here?
More bread. More bread, obviously.
Oh, it's just more bread, mate. No, what's in the bread?
Oh, there's a consequence.
Keep that away.
All right.
Keep it away.
We'll keep this away, but see you guys next week.
Albany Toyota supply us with the Hilux to tow our built-to-fish Surtees boat, which is powered by the economical and reliable Honda outboard. We proudly use the latest gear from Okuma, which we get from Top Catch along with bait, tackle and advice. For more information, pick up the latest copy of NZ Bay Fisher magazine and follow us on Facebook, Fishing and Adventure TV.